Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So I have been getting a lot of questions about what camera do I use for my YouTube channel, and I figured I'd walk you through some of the best cameras that you can use, the three cameras that I think would work great for YouTube, whether you are working on a budget to whether you want to spend a lot more just to invest in your channel. I'm going to also show you how each of them look when I am filming so that you can see how they would be for you as well. So the first one I thought I would show you, and it's probably the most affordable because a lot of you have them, would be a smartphone. So I personally have used this when I'm out and I want to vlog, but I may have forgotten my camera, or my own small camera may have stopped, you know, working because the battery died. So this is basically the iPhone. It's so simple to use when you are filming. The only thing I would recommend, and a lot of new YouTubers actually do not know this, and it is to film, when you start off filming, film it sideways. So you want to do it this way, because if you're doing it this way, all your videos are going to come out like this when you do go to edit them, and it'll have that black screen on either side. So if you want to film, you want to make it where it's a full screen, and this is the only way to do it. With an iPhone, I personally just love the way it looks when you are filming. I don't even have the latest iPhone, which I do want, but this one works just as well when it comes to filming. And the thing I do like about it already, you can download iMovie, which is free. So if you are looking for a free app to edit your videos in, iMovie is already there. When you're done filming, your filming is already inside of your camera. All of the videos are there, so you could just transfer it over to iMovie and work all of it onto your iPhone. That's the best way to do it, and it's the most affordable, especially if you already have an iPhone. Don't feel like you have to go out there and spend a lot of money, because this will work just as well. So this is how it looks if you are filming from the outside camera. Usually I do like how it looks, it's just that I can't see myself when I'm filming. Okay, so the next one is a point and shoot camera, and a lot of YouTubers actually use that when they are vlogging. It's compact, easier to carry around with you. So the one I use is the Canon G7X. It looks just like this. This is more affordable. I'll put the exact price below. I don't remember how much I spent on it. I know it was around $500-$600, I think, when I went to buy it. What I like about the G7X is that it also has a screen that flips out so you can see yourself. Unlike the iPhone, unless you were using the inner camera, which isn't as good as the camera that faces out. Also, what I love about this is if I'm using it, I can connect it with this little button on the side right to my phone. So this would show me exactly what I'm doing right on here, and I can automatically download my photos, download my videos, and it's so convenient. So I would recommend this if you are looking at doing YouTube for the long run, or if you even want just a really nice, affordable camera and you don't want to break the bank, but you are going to be spending a couple hundred dollars for sure on this.
And this is what it looks like filming from the Canon G7X. I do like it, and I like that you are able to see yourself while you are filming.
All right, so the very last, and that is the one that I'm actually filming on right now. It is the Canon 80D. Now, there are more expensive Canon cameras, like the Mark camera, which I would love to have the Mark 5 camera. I just have not invested in it because it's very expensive. That's over $2,000, but for now, I'm using the Canon 80D, and I know I spent a little over $1,000 on it. I want to say it was probably around $1,200 when I purchased it, so now I think you can get a little more affordable. I'm not sure though, so don't quote me on that. But the Canon 80D, I absolutely love, because I personally eventually want to get into doing photography full time. I have already shot a couple weddings with this camera, as well as family shoots. It's just something, if you are interested in doing professional photography, I would recommend getting. Now with the Canon 80D, it is pricey. And then on top of it, you do have to purchase different lenses to get the effect that you want when you are filming. So one of the lenses I'm using right now is the 50mm, but then I also have the 52mm. So this one is $125. The one that I'm using, I believe it's around $300 or $400. So with those two lenses, they do fuzz out your background a lot more the closer I would get to the camera. So if I come a little closer, I don't know if you can see it, it's fuzzing it out just a little bit more. So the more you are closer to the camera, the more it will fuzz out and just give you that bokeh background that everybody loves on YouTube. It is pricey, very pricey, but it is an investment. If you are looking into doing photography, or if you really want nice photos for a blog, which actually, that one worked just as well too. If you are looking for a professional camera, you can't go wrong with the Canon 80D. It's more affordable than the Mark 5, and it will give you everything that you want for your look of YouTube. I, however, do not recommend buying it if you are a beginner. If you are a beginner and you have a couple hundred dollars to spend, the best camera I would get is the Canon G7X. And I know some Instagrammers even use it for their photos. It works great. So if you are looking for something and you're just starting YouTube, don't go out and spend this much on a camera by getting the Canon. That's more of if you want to make it into an investment. Like you've been doing it a couple years, you want to take the splurge and just spend that much. But if you are just looking for something to start you off and you do have a couple hundred dollars to spend, then definitely purchase this because it is worth it. I absolutely love it. This is something that I would recommend for anyone to get, especially as a beginner. So those are my three cameras that I do use, from the more affordable to the more expensive. And I wanted to show you all three just so you can get a view of what works best for you and what you might want to use for your channel or just for your life in general. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know which camera you actually like the best and let me know if there's maybe a camera that you use that I haven't mentioned. Thanks guys so much for watching and of course make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I will have some more tech videos up showing you what type of lighting and things like that that I use for my channel. Thanks guys again so much for watching and I will see you in my next video. Bye.